Alright, I'm going to begin a new Dark Souls character. I've actually gone through the character creation process, but as you can see, he has 8 seconds played, which just means that I started the game and then quit the game. To spare the recording of the character creation process. This isn't really going to be a speedrun, it's just, you know, whatever. Let's have fun with a strength character. And that's what this character is going to be. I'm planning to use the Great Axe. Maybe the Black Knight Great Axe if I find one. But probably the Great Axe. Probably the Manserpent Greatsword. Maybe the Zweihander until I get it. But all strength-based weapons. Not gonna mess around in there. I don't believe I took any gift on this character. Normally I would take the master key, but I decided to give myself a little bit of a challenge and not taking it. My shield button actually is a little weird. It will sometimes stop registering the input, and I'll just drop my shield. So I'm gonna have to use more parrying than blocking, or just overpowering with two-handed attacks. Fraps is hurting my my FPS a little bit, but not too bad. I'm still able to get through. That's a quick way to get his stuff without having to listen through his dialogue, but it does count as sin against you, so later on people can invade you for that. Probably gonna eat an arrow for doing this. Wait, did he miss me even without me evading? Well, that's just embarrassing. The first time I opened that door, it looked like the stairs hadn't loaded yet. My eyes just didn't recognize that as snow on them. It just looked like the texture wasn't there. I won't trade anything with the crow yet. I don't even know if I have anything to trade with the crow yet. I'll skip most cinematics, because I don't really care about them. Well, let's see. Vitality can be my first one up. I'm gonna raise Vitality, Endurance, and Strength pretty much evenly. At least for the time being. Yeah, I'll make the graveyard circuit just to get a few items. I very nearly died there. I'll have to just give up on those ones for now. That Zweihänder is a pretty good strength weapon, at least early on. A lot of people seem to like it later too. I get kind of tired of it. Usually go with the Great Axe, which is a little more satisfying to me. Or the Black Knight Great Axe or the Man Serpent Great Sword. Oh, somebody fell off a ledge. I will take the free souls. Hello. That was pretty foolish of me. Here's an idea. Let's see how long I can go without hollowing. It's been a while since I've done it, so probably not very long, and I'll continue going after I do. But it's always fun to see how far I can actually get with that before I finally die. Let's see, 24, so 16 is the strength I'll need before I can actually wield that. Wield it in two hands, that is. Fire bombs will be useful later. I'm tempted to go get the dragon shield as well, but this shield has good enough fire resist that I really shouldn't do that, especially after I've just reversed hollowing, since I will probably die getting it. Good number of homeward bones to start with is always a good thing. Okay, now that I'm done gathering resources, I can make my way toward our first challenges. Oh, I guess if I don't have the Master Key, I can't get the Dragon Shield yet, can I? So far I'm doing way too much goofing around. Since I'm trying to survive for as long as possible, let's equip that. Since if I die with it equipped, I don't hollow. The Bandit is always my favorite starting class for, well, I mean, it's my favorite starting class in general, but for a strength build especially. I like starting with the Battle Axe, I like starting with the Spider Shield. I like being generally lightweight. I guess the only thing I don't like starting with the Bandit is low intelligence, because usually with a strength build I wind up getting a little bit just for greater magic weapon. And faith, a few points in faith that I just don't use at all, so. Ooh, rubbish. Don't know, rubbish can actually be traded with a crow for, I don't remember what, but nothing great, but better than rubbish. Did I miss an item? I shouldn't do that. I once did get juggled off that little ledge in sort of a buggy way. Getting a little overconfident. Doing lots of foolish stuff right here. Oh, is somebody trying to invade me? That'll probably end my, my not dying real quick.
Well, then you... Thank you, kind.
apparently I'm just bad at getting them with the tip of my axe now. I used to be pretty good at that. I actually don't know why I go this route. I don't use the crossbow that's at the end of it at all, but for whatever reason, there's a part of my brain that will just rebel if I don't do this. Similar with this. The shield in here, completely useless to me. But I'm gonna get it anyway. Clutter up my inventory a bit. So this usually means that somebody is trying to invade me. Sometimes they're successful doing that, sometimes they're not, but I don't know, do I wait around here or do I just push on to the boss? So I'm coming too late. There it is, someone's invading. Let's go back to where... Yeah, this is bad news. That is the problem with running around with Hollowing Reverse. Because I used my Ring of Sacrifice, I've still got Hollowing Reverse. I always forget to go down with one swing. What the hell, chance of humanity. It's odd and amusing that the rats are what have a high chance to drop humanity. one. I got a humanity for that. That's awesome. Will that Zweihander and two hands? Oh, or can I? Maybe I need one more to make it complete. Ow. We'll get there when we get there. That was wonderfully messed up. Got that one with my face. Never pass up the opportunity to kick an enemy off a cliff, I say. Useful bit of trivia, if you do kick an enemy off a cliff and they drop an item, if you exit the game and rejoin, the item will appear on the edge of the ledge you kicked them off of. I love that the backstab animation with the axe, or the parry animation I should say, has you just twirling with an axe. Trying to parry this guy to death might not be the smartest decision I made, but if it works, that's good. I'm just not super confident in my parrying timing right now. Guess that was false modesty. Blue Tearstone Ring boosts my defense when my HP is low. Can I even go into Havel's area? I cannot. I guess I need the watchtower key before I can go in there. Two large shards and two twinkling shards. That's pretty good. Don't know what I'll use those twinkling shards on. Maybe I'll get a good shield or something. Or if I get the Black Knight Great Axe. Before I start this, let's see, there it is. Get myself up to full first. Hoping I'd slide just under that. Victory achieved. I miss the old days when it said, "You defeated." Get burn marks and turn back. Missed my turn. I can't tell you how many times I've accidentally stumbled off that ledge and had to go through that whole area again. Let's do endurance next. Now, I should be able to do the... Oh, I don't have the dexterity for it. That's funny. I didn't even realize that would require dexterity. Guess I've forgotten. I'm not planning to make dexterity a part of this character, but if I get one of the Black Knight weapons, I'll probably have to. Come on down. Come on. Good boy. Oh, usually he charges off. Having him turn around is a little bit scary. Yes, I do hate fighting the rats. Thanks for asking. I didn't get his weapon either. That's a shame. Yeah, I probably have enough for another level now. I might have enough for another if I just use my consumable souls, but I'll save that for a little later. Ooh. Hey. Consider my feelings hurt. This is a completely cheeseball way to fight the boar, but I love when it works. Oh, he did close the gate. Damn. I have done it before where I've just run straight through and gotten through the gate before he snapped it shut, but looks like I have to go the long way around this time. You can see my shield occasionally dropping there. It's because of that button. Somebody else just kindled a bonfire. When someone else kindles a bonfire in the same area that you're in, you get an extra flask. I am playing foolishly. I shouldn't. My parry timing on Black Knights, perfect. My parry timing on lowly zombies, apparently just abysmally bad. Titanite shards are always welcome. Two is even more welcome. Come outside and play. Parrying this guy's a little weird. You don't get the, You don't get the counterattack, and sometimes you'll still take a bit of damage, but he'll still get parried. Or sometimes you'll just fail to parry and eat a mace to your face. This is a little better, I think. I knew I should have just gone. Now that's blocked off. That means someone's trying to invade me again. Hopefully they fail. You look like a worthy ally, my friend. Ran into it right as he was failing to invade. Good news for me. Maybe my bonfire is still broken though. I've had that happen a few times, where someone tries to invade and fails, but then the next bonfire I get to won't just automatically work. Since I'm here, though... let's reinforce this battle axe a bit. It'll serve me well until... I get the great axe, I think.
I'll get you.
Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to exit game and reload and see if that fixes my bonfire. Since I have that spare humanity. And I doubt I have enough to level up. Oh, I do. Yeah, I'll ignore that dexterity. I don't really need to use this Vihonder. And I think this will make a good stopping point for the first video. Thank you for watching.